We're also starting a collection here. Look at all these license plates here. Ontario made yours to discover. So anyways, and yours to keep it beautiful. So anyways, we're gonna see if we can collect a bunch. Everywhere I go, I wanna get some license plates. So got the wall for it. So please send me your license plates. You'll see one of my videos. I've got the address to send to Rodney. So yeah, we're starting a new collection. Aren't we, Pants?
Oh yeah.
Another surprise that we got down in Rodney was we came to the shop the one day and somebody had thrown about 6 sewing machines over the fence. So I'm not complaining, I'm just saying this is pretty cool. This one's a nice ornamental one. It could be made into a nice, decorative craft piece of some sort. You know, it's just stuff like this that, you know, I can't just throw out. You know, I'll use it somewhere someday, somehow. And then same with, you know, I've made my own mailbox before, remember? Well, before that one got all smashed up, but you know, stuff like that, I just kind of toss in a pile. I can't throw it away. I want to use it someday, so I just kind of toss it there, and then I'll use it for something. Busy, busy, busy. Here we are, CanadaCatalyst. So this is one of those light bulbs that have a tendency to get smashed out. And anyways, each one of them has a circuit board. So anyways, you pull it apart, and there you go. So you just take that green board out of there, and that green board is worth money. So you too can be a millionaire. Just have to collect a whole lot of those, and then you'll be laughing. Now, of course, I think once the gases are expelled, the damage is already done to the atmosphere for the fluorescent light there. But yeah, so that's what you want there. I'm sure they don't weigh up much, but yeah. I've had everything adds up, so we got quite a green board collection going on, and someday they'll be worth something. Well, there comes a time when you gotta undercoat everything. Now, we did everything with we used this style. We put this container, we filled it full of fluid film. Like, I got like a five gallon, well, no, it wasn't 5 gallon, I got a 1 gallon container, and I just kept on filling that up. And what we did was we threw it in there, threw this on there, threaded it in, and then we just we put one of these in there, and then we just squirted it, and we got the Mazda all Frankenstein all undercoated. So, you see, it was all nice and clean before we did this. We took the pressure washer to everything underneath, and then we undercoated everything up on the hoist. But now what we're trying to do is we switch, and we're using this undercoat stuff, this drip undercoat. Anyways, this stuff is the same stuff that they use at the fast joints. So anyways, we're just we're taking these old paint canisters that we got from that shop cleanout, and we're just cleaning everything off first, and then we just squirt everything all over it. The pants! How's it ejecting?
Not good.
It's not ejecting that
don't
well.
Don't call me.
Oh. Okay. It's not working worth the crap. This is all stuff that got all clogged up, so we tried to clean it as best we could, and I don't know. So we're trying to undercoat everything, and got another Dakota part out. So got another set of rims that are all nice and gnarly, and got a bumper that's nice and rust free, and another tailgate that's all rust and free. So what we're planning on doing is parting this one out again, and I got a black one that we're working on. But anyways, yeah, we'll get this thing up and going, and we're gonna see about parting it out. Got some interest on it, so we'll see what we can do with this thing. Might be taking it apart and putting it all over eBay. But we'll see what we can do for undercoating. We gotta get it so it's ejecting correctly.
Thread tape. Eject properly everywhere. Just eject all over the whole, you know.
Oh, pants. Oh.
Oh.
You got her all ejected, eh?
Yeah, just gotta leave her.
So this is the air tank that we've been meaning to mount here. Not his final resting spot, but
we're just gonna leave it like that.
Yeah, we're just gonna leave it like that.
Ratchet strap it.
Yeah, ratchet strap it. So anyways, we got this three-wheeler going. We had a heck of a time trying to get it to go again. For whatever reason, the oil capacity was filled up too far. But anyways, we got the big red going, and man, it was a hard time coming, but we got it. And then Twinkie sled, we've been working on that. Found out it's a fuel issue. It'll run perfectly good on a good clean supply of fuel, but the fuel tank was completely clogged up, and it had a whole bunch of crud in it. So anyways, Twinkie, come pick up your sled. It's done. It's come up, and I also need my skid steer seat back. He's in the upholstery business here, and he's helping us out here at CanadaCatalyst. And of course, we cleaned up some stainless steel as well this morning in our free time, so now that's all got to be put away. But it's been a busy, busy, busy day here. We got everything done that we need to get done. So I'm told that we have to get this key coated. Now, what I don't understand is the key is just a regular cut key. It's not an FOB. I have an FOB down in Rodney, but anyways, I gotta pay $60 to get it coated. So, yeah. Now you're gonna say though, well, that's just a different door. But anyways, that key won't work in that lock on the door for whatever reason. But this door is the same as the back half of the car, and then this door is one that we stole off of another car down in Rodney. And then when we bought this car, it had a Gulf front end put on it. So there's two shades of blue here. Well, actually, I think probably three shades of blue. Anyways, yeah, the key that for the ignition here, I think they bypass it because it should not be able to start here. See, look at this. That key, that thing flashing right there is your immobilizer. So anyways, that's probably the culprit why it won't start. So I'm just gonna drop it off at the dealer and get them to get another key for this thing. I think I'm gonna take one of my spare FOBs and bring it in there, and they can make another key for this car, and then maybe it'll be able to lock and unlock this. So anyways, we'll get to the bottom of this one way or another. We gotta get this freaking car done. It is holding up production here. But yeah, we're busy cleaning some eaves troughs this morning. This is a weird time of the year for it to be really warm. And we took advantage of the nice weather this morning, and we got a bunch of eaves troughs cleaned on two houses. Last time they called me was last week when it had snow on the side of the roads. So yeah, anyways, we got that all cleaned up. So we've been busy here at CanadaCatalyst.
Oh yeah. Yep.